system that could really
tell your local forecast.
Turbulent weather is plaguing many eastern states this morning. You've already had some snow, even as far south as the deep south. And the snow will eventually be spreading across the northeast later on today. And there's also been some heavy rain, too, along the eastern seaboard. And Florida has been especially hard hit with both heavy rain and severe thunderstorms. Good morning and welcome to this edition of WeatherScope. I'm Cheryl Lemke. Now we have more details about this storm situation, and with more, here's Bruce Edwards in our forecast center. Bruce?
Thank you, Cheryl, and good morning, everyone. Really, over the last several days in Florida, we've had a lot of heavy rain, but now we enter or add a different element to the heavy rain, and that is the threat of severe weather. As some suspected tornadoes spotted early this morning in parts of central Florida, and there is still a tornado watch in effect. We take a look at, again, everybody wading around. Hip boots were the order of the day. If you got some from Santa Claus, you're in luck. And I tell you, this guy needed them. As you can see, there's widespread flooding across Florida yesterday, especially parts of the central state. Earlier downpours caused serious flooding yesterday evening, and heavy rain, of course, began to return once again today and over the overnight hours. And there's been more heavy downpours continuing. And there's better news on the horizon, but for the immediate future, the rain continues to pelt down. And I'll tell you, the month of December has been just awful as far as rainfall. Look at Tampa's normal rainfall during the month of December. 1.82 inches of rain. Okay, not bad. But through Christmas, 10.3 inches of rain has fallen in Tampa, Florida, officially, for the first 25 days of the month. And as you can see, Jacksonville, normally about 2 3/4. They've had 9.5 and still have more of that added over the last couple of days. Orlando, 1.78 is normal through the 25th. Well, they've had 8.63. And again, more of that has been added over the last couple of days. So again, those totals continue to mount into central Florida. We look at the low pressure area. This is what formed in the Gulf of Mexico. Again, it formed down here and continued to work its way onto the northeast as it is doing right now. And it's helped spawn really a couple of batches of wet weather. One here to the north of the front through the Florida Panhandle and into South Georgia and the Carolinas. The other one just ahead of the front in the warmer air. And this is the one here that has been responsible for the severe weather and the severe thunderstorms that have moved through. Now, the Storms Prediction Center has a tornado watch in effect for the red shaded region of Florida until 10 a.m. Eastern Time. Now, the extreme northwest corner here around Appalachian Bay and the Florida Big Bend around Tallahassee, that has been eliminated. eliminated from the watch area. However, the rest of it remains in effect for, once again, another hour and a half or so. And you can see one batch of moisture here appears to be weakening here, this northernmost part, although we appear to be seeing another little line of storms forming from the outflow just to the west of Jacksonville. And, of course, the main batch has been right here through the central part of the state, and this is the one that has brought some severe storms to the Tampa Bay vicinity. Now, Daytona Beach, New Smyrna Beach, Titusville here, seeing some heavier downpours through Orlando. But as you can see, we're getting a little bit better here in Tampa Bay as the line is sagging to the south, so the heavier weather is moving towards Port Charlotte, Sarasota, and Bradenton, Florida. Now, as all that weather heads east, what we have here is some snow. That's right, some snow in the Cumberland Plateau, eastern Kentucky, and some of the mountainous areas of the Carolinas and Georgia on up into Virginia and West Virginia. This is primarily all the, we're getting snow back in through here, and then you can see the moderate to heavy rain running from Chesapeake Bay through Richmond and right on down through the Carolina coast. I tell you, if you're traveling 995, you have to do it this morning. It is very, very wet, just about the entire length from Virginia all the way down into Florida. As you get farther north now, the mountains of West Virginia up into Pennsylvania, we've got some snow here once again. And this whole snow area is expected to sort of sag a little closer to the coast as the low works its way on offshore. We're seeing the cloud cover associated with it now. And again, light snow into New York and Pennsylvania. A little heavier as you get into the mountains of West Virginia, which is good news to places like Snowshoe and the ski resorts there and Greenbrier Valley, but not so good if you have to do traveling around I-81 and I-77. There you can see the precipitation moving on through, and once again, snowfall primarily is what we're looking at here. And we will see some snow moving into places like Charlottesville, the nation's capital, Baltimore, Philly, and eventually into New York as we work through the course of the day. Locally, again, we could see 6 inches of snow in the spine of the mountains, but 3 to 6 inch swath is pretty much expected here all throughout this region of the Appalachian. So a little taste of winter weather on this week after Christmas. Now, we have another storm that could be brewing over the next few days. We'll talk more about that in a few minutes, but now let's check out what else is going on across the country. Here again is Cheryl Emke.
A storm system from the Pacific Northwest could bring some heavy snow to parts of the east by early next week. Today, however, the system is bringing some strong winds across Colorado and Montana, with some snow, though, up in the mountains. Well, as we check out the latest surface map, you can see that we have really tightly packed isobars throughout the Rockies and across parts of the Pacific Northwest. Well, whenever you see a surface map and you see the isobars lined up as they are like now, right across Montana, Idaho, and Wyoming, that always indicates some really fierce surface winds. And currently, high wind warnings are out for most of the Rockies, even extending down towards the Denver metro area, a high wind warning in effect. It may not be uncommon to see winds up at the higher mountain passes gusting over 70 miles an hour. So some tremendous winds today, and we can't overemphasize